There's a couple hours until the hockey game. And the arena.
Panthers, some players every game step up. They want to be heroes. And Anthony Duclair, two goals in that game, forcing it overtime. And then, of course, Jonathan Huberdeau. What an amazing play. Persistent, that anticipation, stripping the defensive on the puck going in. And on the second try, he moves it on Gibson. Another exciting home game for the Florida Panthers. And as you said, now they're going for nine straight wins, nine straight at home.
It's been remarkable. I haven't lost a home game since late February. That game against Edmonton. Huberdeau went there tonight. Second in the NHL in scoring. Let's check in with Coach Andrew Rudin.
Yeah, I think we stay at home. You know, a constant for us at home is kind of dictating the game, how we want to play it, and the pace we want to play that. It's no different tonight. We understand that we're going to push pretty hard early. And I think for us, it's just more focus on ourselves. Again, falling behind in a lot of hockey games of late, so I think for us, just that mentality to need to get ahead tonight. And again, that's by dictating and playing our game, and we've been doing a good job to get points.
The team is scoring more points in the game, it's tough to do so right now. Do you attribute that to the depth of talent you have from the line that you keep just rolling out?
Yeah, I think for sure. Absolutely, definitely. I think it talked about a little bit yesterday. Teams that play us, they don't just have to worry about Markey's line, and they're going to the UB's line, and if they shut those two down, and we have the luxury of having a Rhino and Lundy marching on the third line, and Lucy and the former third goal scorer on the fourth line. So we have depth, and the skill level for the lineup is for sure a big reason where we're at.
If I follow up, I don't know if you have noticed this, but I think I've noticed that some people have sent me some messages saying that this December, if you score your best goal, this is a song that they play. And I guess fans wait for it. It's called the Mambo number 5. You guys score 5 or more goals.
Way over my head. I've never heard that. That actually sounds catchy, but I have not heard that.
The Panthers enter tonight's game with five players with at least 25 goals. Two of them, Alexander Barkov and Anthony Duclair, already have 30, and others are close enough to join. It shows the depth the Panthers have up and down their lineup. That's part of the focus as we send it over to Katie Dawes.
Oh yeah, drinking. I've got a year left to I can do that. Although I'm not going to. You know, just because it's not good for me. That's gonna go. Oh wow! Wow, that stayed in. How did that stay in the zone? Wow, that's nuts. That's crazy, dude. Icing. Fucking floss in 2022. What? Barky. Oh! Steal it! Oh, they recovered. They recovered. They recovered. They recovered. Damn. Rush down. Rush. Oh. Oscar Rush, boys.
Okay. Yeah. No.
Oof. Oh, can I fall back? Okay. They got back. Oh. Oh, boy. Oh. Steal.
Yep.
Okay. Good cover. Rice. Oh, made it. Oh. Was it a goal? Was it not? Are they reviewing the play? Okay. Can we replay that? Let me see. Get them?
I didn't get them yet. I mean, they're because they don't have a time or a date or
yeah. No, but I mean, you said you bought.
It just says game one at home.
Wow, I didn't know that. Well, thank you, that's pretty awesome that you're able to do it already.
Yeah,
because I was gonna say they don't know who their opponent is yet.
No, they don't, but they just said it. Opponent is TBD, time is TBD, day is TBD,
but still game one. I didn't know you're able to get them because you told me they're so expensive.
I mean, we're high up in, like, here, you know.
Yeah, well, I don't mind it. Again, I'd be happy to just go, like, right now. Oh.
I think we're over there somewhere.
Okay.
On that side somewhere.
Okay, well, it'll still be awesome. It'll be my first playoff game ever.
Yeah. It's part of your happy birthday, I guess.
Oh, the playoffs going to be after my birthday this year, though. As they said in the pregame for a couple more weeks.
Yeah, but, I mean, it's still part of your, I guess it would be part of your birthday gift.
Yeah, I suppose. Elton, I guess. You're not wrong. Hey, look. Ukraine! Norwich, Ukraine!
I actually have somebody that I have my bowling that's going also with us, because I was able to get four.
Really?
Because they asked me to get two for them.
Uh-huh.
So we're going to be sitting next to
the people you bowl with?
One of the guys I used to bowl with for years, yeah. And then the other guy I don't really know. But.
Okay.
But yeah, they'll be sitting next to us.
That's pretty cool, though.
Yeah, it was pretty cool.
It is. In hot.
Let's go, Panthers.
Oh, hit him. Do this.
Let's go, Panthers.
Let's go, boys.
Let's go,
I think only has five shots so far.
Yeah. Oh, about to get the six. Six. Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah. Oh, oh, there was a six. Oh, oh, oh. Oh, there they go. Oh, there they go. There they go. We're going. We're going. We're going. You do, Bob. Nothing with that. Okay. Nothing with that. Oh, there's the, there goes the rescue sock.
Yeah.
This is the second time tonight.
Panthers penalty to number 62, Brandon Montour. 2 minutes for tripping. Time of the penalty, 14 minutes of the first period.
I don't know.
Montour, 2 for tripping at 14 minutes.
I don't know. It kind of like one of our guys maybe made him flip. One of them.
Yeah.
But I don't, by that little skirmish, it looks like it didn't do anything tomorrow to another penalty from anybody.
Disallowed 2-0 the score after 20 minutes. Let's take a look at the high- highlights from the first period. Starting things off, the Jonathan Huberto line, a blast from Giroux off the back wall of Huberto, grabs that juicy rebound for his 29th of the season to put the Cats on the board first. He's pumped up as always, continuing to add to his point total. And then that line back at it again, Giroux with a gorgeous feed across the slot, finds Huberto, who shows so much great patience with that, sliding it under the leg of Hellebuck to make it 2-0 for your Cats. But they certainly weren't done yet. However, no more of the goals would count. Here's a look at the first goal that was disallowed. Mammon poking it in front of the net, and Hornquist was crashing in against the stick in the mix, and it looks like it crosses the line. You can see it. There it goes, clearly over. However, it was called a goal that a coach's challenge from the Jets would be. Setting it up, puck flies high on the rebound, and Lundell gets a stick on it to send it in. No goals counted as we are at 2-0, and I had a chance to speak with Joe Giroux at 2 assists in that first period.
Well, so it seems like you guys knew exactly what you wanted to do when you hit the ice for this game. What can you say about the effort, especially to start your line getting a goal in your first shift?
Well, I think Lundy's line had a great start. They went through in their zone and got momentum for us, and we're just trying to keep it simple early in the game, and we're able to get points.
80% of the goals right now in hockey are being scored right around the net. How much focus do you guys put on that in terms of knowing that the danger that that can bring and getting those rebound opportunities?
Yeah, that's something we focus on, especially at the end of the season. That's where you score your goals. You got to be able to get in there. Maybe that's why I don't score a lot of goals, but when you go in there, there's going to be bounces, and just like you read the throws.
Well, I saw your son down by the glass for warm-ups. How nice is it to be able to have your family joining you here and enjoying South Florida hockey?
Well, it's great. Every time he's got a chance to come to the game, he's pretty fired up. And the next day, that's all he talks about. And he loves Bob and Matt. He just loves watching him play. Just hopefully this will become a goal.
Thanks so much, Claude. Good luck in the third, second.
Yeah, Claude, you were saying his son.
Down. Thank you. How do we do it? I'd be shitting my pants, pissing them off.
Well, not if you're just in the stands. That's different.
But still. Maybe it's just my type, but you know, I'm not all the people looking at me. Not the most comfortable.
Well, see, that doesn't bother me if I'm in the stands. If I was standing out there, that's different.
Well,
a lot more nerve-wracking.
I mean, it wouldn't be as nerve-wracking on the board, but it'd still be just a little bit nerve-wracking. Just a little bit. Just a little bit. Because I know there'll be eyes looking at me through that. There'll be a little bit nerve-wracking for me. The shots are even now, it looks like.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. They did that, not us. Oh, okay. Oh, nice. Whoa, okay, wow, good moves. Nope, running back. Oh, he's going fast. Woo!
Yeah.
Oh! Rush the other way, boys. Oh, we don't have it. Yeah, it was. It was. And then we're going back again. Oh! Shit! Let's go, boys. Ooh.
Take the next step in becoming the ultimate Florida Panthers fan by joining joining the Panthers Kids Club. Members of the Kids Club receive exclusive benefits, content, to stay informed on all things Panthers. Visit FloridaPanthers.com/Kids Club for more information.
All right, there, Panthers fans, I tell you what, pretty warm and humid outside, a lot cooler in here. Once you head back outside, we're going to be talking about mid-70s overnight tonight. Most of that rain should be out of here, a few spotty showers. And then if we see any action tomorrow, Saturday, to kick off the weekend, probably early in the day, only about a 20% chance. Otherwise, it'll be very warm and humid. And then kind of carrying into Easter Sunday, looking to be even drier. Of course, you can catch all our forecasts on there online, and be sure to download the NBC 6 app.
Welcome back, Cat fans. I'm Katie Dawes with your second period intermission report presented by Coke Zero Sugar. Well, the Cats picking up where they left off in the first, 2-4 goals. Let's take a look at the highlights from that second period, starting off with a gorgeous save from Sergei Bobrovsky. There you see, throwing that blocker up high. Really nice work by Bob. He's done a great job to keep the Jets off the board in this game to give the Panthers a chance to add to their lead. Look at this pass from Reinhardt. 85 feet, finds Forsling on the blue line, streaking in. Great patience. He certainly wasn't done yet. Jonathan Huberdeau continuing to add to his point total this season. Finds Forsling breaking down the ice. Looks like it takes a little deflection in front. You see it hitting off the stick of the defender and beating Hellebuck on the 5-hole. One more look. Forsling, great shot. Continuing his impressive offensive production and career highs this season, gives the Cats a 4-0 lead after 2 periods. And I had a chance to chat with the goal scorer, Gustav Forsling, after the second period.
Gustav, 2 goals for Huberdeau in the first, 2 goals for you in the second. Did you guys decide to have a competition tonight?
Not really. It's not every day I score 2 goals in one period, so feels good.
Well, in all seriousness, you said it right there. You know, your offensive touch, you're adding to your career high that you already broke this season for scoring. What has been working so well for you in the offensive side of your game?
I don't know. To be honest, I get a lot of trust out there. I play a lot of minutes and play with some of the really great players, so it's a lot of fun.
In the last few games, you've really started to notice this concern, this extra effort for you guys defensively. What have you noticed this team maybe doing a little differently, or just really applying that extra focus to the defensive side of the game?
I think we're just trying to keep it a little more simple. Everybody should be doing their little extra small things, getting out of the zone.
Bob's certainly not hurting it either. He seems pretty locked in tonight.
Yeah, for sure. It's a lot of fun.
All right, thanks, Gustav. Good luck in the third.
Thank you.
Yeah, lots of good things happening for the Cats offensively and defensively in this game. Let's take a look at the game stats presented by Emmerich. 4-0 the score. The shots even. Both sides 26 apiece, really showing the impressiveness of the Cats' defensive effort in this game. 16-13 the shots, and still no one breaking through on that power play. We give credit to the Cats' PK, 4-4 so far tonight. All right, it is time now for our Panthers prospect report. Tonight we're doing things a little differently, sending it down to the barn to check in with the Charlotte Checkers. Their captain, Zach Dalton, who recently played in his 600th pro game. He's in his 12th pro season and currently has 37 points for the Checkers this year. A big part of that team as they push towards the playoffs and a big leader on and off the ice. So congratulations to Zach, and we look forward to focusing in more on the Checkers as they make their run towards the playoffs. All right, that does it for this intermission report. Here's a look back at the second period highlights presented by Geico.
Like before.
Oh my.
Oh.
They have to score four more times to get 10. That's a lot. I don't think it's going to happen.
Yeah.
That's a lot.
Panthers!
Goal!
Game 6 of the season, scored by number 98, Maxime Mathis! Assisted by number 52, McKenzie Weaver! 7 minutes of the third period. Mammon is 6 from Weger at 7 minutes even.
7 minutes even. Oh! Oh! Whoa! Oh, shit!
7 p.m. Join us for the last regular season game against the Tampa Bay Lightning on Sunday, April 24th at 7 p.m. Tickets are on sale now at Ticketmaster.com. Calling all blockheads, new kids on the block is bringing their mixtape tour to FLA Live Arena on July 9th. Get your tickets now.
Rush, Berkey! Oh! Man, those are so close. It's hilarious.
Scoring change on the six Panthers goal. Credit and assist to Patrick Hornquist. Matt, his six from Weaver and Hornquist at 7 minutes of the third period.
Hornquist! Man, 70 shots this whole game combined. My God.
Yeah, no, it's been a lot of shots.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Jonathan Huberto.
Huber!
Another interview with you. I know you're getting a little bit tired of us, but 32 home wins for this team. This crowd and this fan base has been waiting a long time for a team like this. How much pride do you guys take in being the team to give back to them and play here every night?
Thursday night, when they take on the Detroit.